Oh no, it's waking up! Hang on, it's still groggy. I'm going to find the right spell to open the next door. It better not wake up or we'll be in big trouble. Charm all of these objects out of its way. A close one. Let's see what's next. Looks like you'll have to choose the cup that contains the knight and the shield. Did you see the symbol on the shield? It looks like an ice potion. That must be what we need to get through the fire. Only one. I'm going to find some help.
I wondered whether I'd be meeting you here, Potter. You're far too inquisitive to remain among the living. Damn you, Potter!
But, Master, it wasn't my fault.
Harry Potter, give me the stone. I know you have it.
Let me speak to him face to face.
But Master, you're not strong enough.
I have strength enough for this. Hand over the stone.
Die, Potter!
Thank you.
stone. You will yield to me, Potter. Very well. I promise you'll die begging for mercy as your parents did.
Dumbledore smiled. What happened down in the dungeons between yourself and Professor Quirrell is a complete secret, he said. So naturally, the whole school knows. The stone had been destroyed, but Harry remained fearful that its loss would not prevent Lord Voldemort's return. Dumbledore nodded, sharing his concern. Nevertheless, Harry, if our battles do no more than slow Voldemort's return, with luck, he may never regain his power at all. Harry made his way down to the end-of-the-year feast alone that night. The Great Hall was decked out in green and silver to celebrate Slytherin winning the House Cup. When Harry entered, there was a sudden hush. He took a seat between Ron and Hermione, trying to ignore the stares of the other students. "The House Cup," announced Dumbledore, "is awarded to the team with the most house points. At the moment, that would seem to be Slytherin." A storm of cheering and stamping broke out from the Slytherin table. "However," continued Dumbledore, "in recognition of Mr. Harry Potter's pure nerve and outstanding courage, I award Gryffindor 60 points. Harry's table erupted with cheers and applause. The additional point had won the House Cup for Gryffindor. It was the best evening of Harry's life. Better than winning at Quidditch or Christmas or knocking out mountain trolls. He would never, ever forget tonight.